Hey guys, welcome to another video. In this video, we'll be looking at the iMac that just got released about 2-3-4 months ago with the 5700 XT. I've got an i9 in there that is a 3.6 gigahertz. I've got 16 gigs of RAM as well, all Apple RAMs. Now, on top of that, I'm putting that against a MacBook Pro 16 inch with an i9 again. Last gen, where the i9 in the iMac is a 10th gen, the i9 in the MacBook Pro is a 9th gen, 2.3 gigahertz, so a lot weaker, still 16 gigs of RAM at 266 megahertz, so the RAMs are the same. The only difference is I'm running an eGPU, the AMD RX 5800 XT. And it's a AIB version, so it's by ASRock and it's their Tai Chi, which is, in my experience so far, a mammoth of a card, and it's so good. It's really, really good. I'll have in the comments the review of that card. I've done a review of that card. You guys can have a look. It's a beautiful, magnificent card. If you want a 6800 XT and you want to not get the reference card and you want to get a AIB card, you want a really, really good one, look at the Tai Chi. Look at my review, look at the stats, look at the graphs, look at the whole thing. It's well worth it. Anyways, I'm putting that in an eGPU and connecting it to my MacBook Pro, and I'm going to be running some benchmarks and I'm going to be running some games, and in the end I'll be having some graphs and we'll discuss it all together. All right guys, please do make sure you stay till the end so you do understand what's going on a little bit more. I've really worked hard on this. I'll let you guys go. You guys can enjoy the side-by-side of all the benchmarks and games, and I'll catch you guys at the end. Thank you.
geared up. Head up to street level. You'll find supplies there.
Mark's about to pass out. We need to stop soon.
Okay, we'll do that. I don't think we've been properly introduced. I'm Ryan. That over there is Erin. She's a doctor of the group. Jennifer's a scavenger and... Come. Well, you can ask him yourself what he thinks of her.
I'm Jake. I'm a private to the resistance. Pacific.
Pacific? You're a long way from home. What you doing down here?
My entire division is wiped out. I'm trying to get in touch with the South Division. I've got a message for Commander Barry.
So, it's true? The Annihilation Line's coming?
It wasn't the Annihilation Line. It was something else.
Then what was it?
To be honest, I'm not sure myself.
God damn it! That's as far as this piece of shit will go.
Let's get off the road. Pull up over there. We got some time on them, so let's not lose our heads.
I'll be on the fucking lookout for 10 seconds.
Erin, you do what you think is best for Vaughn. I'll see what I can do about the bus. Jacob, it might take a while, so can you look inside and see if it's safe to stay?
Sure. Jennifer, would you help me?
Sure.
Alright guys, let's get into some benchmarks. Starting off, looking at the scores from Unigen Heaven benchmark. Wow guys, I didn't expect the EGPU to do this well, okay? In the bench, obviously this is not real world, okay? So in the benchmark, it scored nearly double, okay? That's really, really cool. I really like that. The VRAM on both of these are the same. The only difference you'll be getting is basically... The 5700 XT has mature drivers. It's been out for a while. It's had the games that are optimized to it, and it's got the drivers that have matured properly. And other than that, it's been on the market for a while, so everything's really good on it. It's got the same VRAM as the 6800 XT. It's a very special one that they put in the IMAX. Other than that, not to mention the 5700 XT is directly connected to the logic board, so it'll be getting about over 120 gigabits per second, whereas the MacBook Pro eGPU setup is limited to 40 gigabits over the cable, so it'll be going back and forth. And I've done the absolute best setup for both, so I've got the right drivers for both, you know. I've got the throttle stop and max fan and everything like that for both the computers and things like that to run in boot camp. And I've also, for the eGPU, I've got it connected to an external display and all that stuff. So that's still pretty impressive for me. I didn't think it would be that huge a difference. Now, moving on to Unigen Heaven benchmark with the average FPS. So the average FPS, again, nearly double. The medium FPS is not much there, and the maximum FPS is more than double. So that's really impressive with that. Let's move off to the next benchmark. So 3D Mark benchmark. So straight off, you'll have the score. Not much there, but it's still impressive. It's in the mid 1200, so that's 12,000, so that's nearly 12,000 more than the other one. The amazing thing you'll see here is if you look at the green line, which is the GPU score, the GPU in the MacBook Pro isn't that good. It's a laptop CPU. The CPU is a laptop CPU, whereas the iMac CPU is a desktop CPU. On top of that, the iMac one has two extra cores, four extra hyper-threading cores. that it gets, and also it's a 10th gen, whereas the MacBook Pro is a 9th gen. So you can see the difference there. It's nearly doubled in the score. However, this is where it makes a difference, because most of the games will be bottlenecked by the CPU. And if you look at this, GPU, and if you look at the GPU, which is the red line, and the MacBook Pro with the eGPU scores a lot better, more than double that the iMac does. Now let's see if these translate into real world gaming experiences. So looking at Total War Warhammer benchmark, to my surprise, it was beaten by the iMac internal GPU. I thought they would be the eGPU would do a little bit better or a little bit worse. I didn't think it'll be off by a whole 12 or 13 frames per second. Moving on to the next games are more in line to what I thought. So looking at Resident Evil, I was getting around 123 frames per second, whereas on the iMac I only got around 79. Going on to the next game I tested, which was a Plague Tale, so there again nearly double the frames per second, so 114, whereas the iMac just scored 58, which is not that good. Going on to Terminator Resistance, so I've got a bit of a all of the games. So Terminator Resistance, for those of you who don't know, is a first person shooter. The other games aren't. So in the first person shooter, the MacBook Pro with the eGPU was nearly half of what the iMac was doing. So the iMac really beat it out, 69 frames per second, whereas the MacBook Pro 36 frames per second. All right guys, that brings the testing and video to the end. So basically, I would like to just point out the 5800 XT isn't as mature graphic-wise, drivers-wise. For example, it's just got one drivers available at the moment. A lot of games aren't optimized for it. It's just very new. And the Tai Chi one, please, guys, in the end and in the comments, please do go and check out my review of the Tai Chi 6800 XT, which I've got in this eGPU. And when I did test that in that video, it's not in an eGPU, it's working with a Ryzen processor. So have a look at that, guys. All right, but that is a beast of a graphic card. So it's a bit disappointing and it's a bit everywhere when you look at it. But overall, if you were thinking of putting it in, first things you got to know is macOS does not support it. I don't know if it will, because as you know, with Apple, they only start support once they get that graphic card in one of their computers. So like if the 5800 XT goes into a Mac Pro and that option is available by them, then only would it be supported on all the Macs. So don't hold your breath for it to work on Mac. So if you've got one lying around, or if you got your hand on one and if you want to chuck it in the eGPU, it does work, okay? So it does work in Windows and you can get it to work and things like that. However, I wouldn't waste my time and money on it. I would actually put it in a PC. But this was just a bit of a fun that I wanted to have with you guys. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know in the comments what you want to see more. I was thinking of maybe even putting in the 6800 XT against in a eGPU against an eGPU against the 5700 XT Sapphire. I have the link for that as well, the unboxing of the Sapphire 5700 XT, if you guys want to have a look. That's a Pulse. And yeah, let me know if you guys want to see anything else like this. Thanks for watching. Alright guys, so if you want to see more videos and support the channel and you like this video, please give me a like, thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Also check out my Twitter, Instagram and Patreon accounts. That helps a lot if you follow them and contribute there. Thanks so much. Take care. Bye.